Parashat Shemot Shelishi. So now Moshe Rabbeinu, he grows up, and he leaves the palace, the place where he was raised. And when he leaves, he sees the burden and the condition of Am Yisrael, his Jewish brothers. So when he goes out, he sees the Egyptian man hitting a Jew. And Moshe Rabbeinu couldn't handle it, so he looks right, he looks left, and he hits the Egyptian. Rav Sadia Gaon says that he didn't intend to kill him, but nevertheless, that happened. And therefore he buried him. So the next day again, he goes outside the palace and he sees this time two Jews fighting. Hamim tell us it was Datan and Aviram. And Moshe Rabbeinu, he rebukes the evil one, the one that was about to hit his friend. However, the evil one responds back to Moshe Rabbeinu saying, "Are you going to kill me just like you killed the Mitzri yesterday?" So Moshe Rabbeinu, he never thought that the Jewish people would slander him and spread the rumor about what he did, because he was helping a Jewish brother. However, once he saw that there's a Jew like this that's going to spread the rumor, he knew his life was in danger, and Paro is going to want to kill him. So Moshe Rabbeinu, he went off to Midian. And in Midian, he went to a well, and the daughters of Yitro also were there to go and feed the animals of Yitro. But what happened was is that the daughters of Yitro were bullied, and Moshe Rabbeinu saved the day. So the daughters of Yitro come back home, and they come back very early. And Reuel is actually a machloket. Was Reuel, is it actually Yitro, or is it the father of Yitro? And it calls the Reuel the father of the girls, because a grandfather is also like a father. It could be called a father. So anyways, Reuel says, "What happened? How'd you come home so early?" And the daughters explain what happened. So Reuel says, "Hey, you have to bring him over." So they get Moshe. He gets himself comfortable there, he decides to stay there, and he even marries the daughter of Yitro, Tzipora, and has a son, Gershom. The Torah then tells us, Vayamat Melech Mitzrayim, that the Paro, he passed away. However, Rashi explains that he really didn't die, it was the same Paro. However, he just had a very bad, severe case of Tzarat. And Hachamim tell us that every day, in the morning and night, he would kill 150 baby, so 300 in total. And he thought that this would be a remedy if he takes a bath with the blood of the Jewish babies. Others actually say that there was a new king. The Torah ends off in this parasha, in the Aliyah, that Hashem, he hears the cries of Bnei Israel and he connects himself to them.